So here there are three case studies. So as I said, these case studies always being studied with respect to the various point of view. So the first case studies, you could see it is a personal insulin pump. You know the functionality of an insulin pump. So basically it is an embedded system. Insulin pump, it is an embedded system. In fact, here the software controls a hardware device, and that hardware device is embedded in the device. So what are the issues basically with respect to this embedded system? It include the usability, what you know is a security, and how do we control this particular medical device. Similarly, the next case study that would take is an information system, a database. This system basically is designed to manage and provide access to the database of information. What could be the issues in this information system? Again, it includes security, usability, a privacy of a patients, that is their information, and maintaining the data integrity, that is relevancy, given the relevancy. So usually it is a medical, maintaining the medical record systems in the case of mental patients. The third case studies that we take is, it is a basically sensor based data collection system. Here many sensors, that is a system whose primary purpose is to collect the data from many sensors being connected, and the same data will be processed. The key requirement of such systems are reliability, that is, even in the tough hostile environmental condition, it should be able to give the correct information from the collected data, and maintainability. So let me go to the first case study, insulin pump. The functionality of an insulin pump has been given here. An insulin pump is a, as I said, embedded system that simulates the operations of various internal organs, that is measuring the level of the sugar level. In fact, here also we use a sensor. The system helps you to help the diabetes patients. So who suffer from diabetes use this system. So one of the problem with the treatment in this disease, that if the level of insulin required does not just depends upon the blood glucose level, but also on the time of the last time insulin injected. Got it. That is, the problem with this treatment is that if the level of insulin required does not just depend upon the just blood glucose level, but also depends on the how long before the insulin injection has been injected. That is, there could be a fluctuation in the level of blood glucose. Or maybe there is a high level of blood sugar. The consequence is low blood sugar in the short term could be more serious, as it might lead to the brain malfunctioning. Similarly, the vice versa. The high blood sugar also may lead to some kind of health related issues. Our objective here is, here we have a software controlled insulin delivery system. You could see the diagram. Here we have insulin pump architecture. It is an hardware architecture. A software controlled insulin, it might work using a sensors that is embedded in the hardware to measure the blood parameters, that is the glucose level. Then we have here a pump controller. The controller actually, it computes the sugar level. In fact, it computes the sugar level. So it identifies how much amount of insulin is being needed to the blood. Then this controller sends the signal to pump to deliver the insulin through a attached needle. So it is almost like a hardware device that identifies. See, we have the hardware being that is being connected with the clock. We have an alarm. So this insulin pump hardware architecture is a hardware device that is being connected to a patient who suffer from a blood glucose problem. So either the sugar level may be low or may be high. If it is low, what to be done? And it is high, what has to be done? So what sort of insulin? So at what level it has to be injected, that will be identified. So this is a hardware architecture. This is a hardware architecture. So you could see different types of displays, display one, display two. We have a controller. So I said, what is the functionality of a controller? In fact, the controller majorly computes the sugar level and it identifies the amount of insulin that is being needed. So this figure shows the hardware component and how the insulin pump is displayed in the hardware. The downside diagram is a unified modeling language. It is called activity model because each individual oval is an activity starting from a source to the target. So I told this is a bullseye that identifies the target, and the source is always being represented with a single dot. So in fact, in the module 2, you will understand what is unified modeling language and also activity models. The concepts of object and classes are being studied over here. This UML activity model, in fact, it illustrates how the software transforms an sugar level, that is input or sugar level, to a sequence of commands so that the insulin pump can drive with respect to the data. So in fact, if I say it is one of the good device to maintain a sugar level for a patient who is suffering from glucose problem, and it is one of the safety critical systems. In the case if the pump fails to operate or it doesn't operate correctly, then the health of a patient may be damaged, or they may fall into a wrong prescription of a blood sugar level, that is unable to identify whether it is low or high. Henceforth, there are major high level requirement that has to be met by this insulin pump. So what could be this high level requirement? The high level requirement is this: the system should be available to deliver at any time the insulin to a patient whenever it is required, and also the system shall perform reliable and deliver the correct amount of insulin based on the current sugar level. So overall, if I could conclude this case study, the system is actually being designed and implemented to ensure that it should meet the above two requirement perfectly. So next case is a mental care system. So overall, the short name is MHC-PMS. So mental health care patient management system, that is you mental health care patient management system. In fact, this is an information system, so it is being used to use in small clinics. So as the name itself indicates, management system means we have a data. It makes use of a centralized database of the patient information, so that could be run on one of the personal computer, so that it could be accessed and used from the various sites with the secure network and connectivity. The patient information is stored in the database, but they can be downloaded and used for local copies of the patient record whenever they are needed. In fact, the system is not the complete medical record, so it may not maintain information about the medical condition. So this figure illustrates the how does the organization of the mental health care system, that is patient management system, is being connected with the servers